The EG4 Bright Mount is one of the most popular ground mounts on the market. It costs $279. We actually have a sweet little discount code you can use to save 25 bucks, which makes this $254, which is not a terrible price. It's not Amazon cheap, but it's also not Bill Gates expensive. So today we're gonna slap this thing together and find out if it's worth the hype or if you're better off just going with one of the $100 Amazon options. Because as you guys know, here at the lab, our opinions cannot be bought. Right away, I'm actually happy with the size of this box. A lot of the other ground mounts that you can buy, they break down, so they ship in a much smaller package. But that also makes them a little bit more flimsy once they're assembled. There's a lot more sag and nuts and bolts going on. So over the summer, we've accumulated a shitload of panels. Right now, our favorite big panel is this Sirius 415-watt bifacial panel that you can actually get from Signature Solar. It says it's a half inch bigger than what this is able to hold, but we're hoping we're gonna be able to get them to fit on here. So let's get started and see just how good this EG4 Bright Mount really is. So this is everything that comes in the box. Right away, we got a couple bags of hardware, a couple pieces of hardware that feel like they should be in bags. But like immediately, look at this, the thickness and the quality of these pieces. If you're trying to decide like if the $250 price point is kind of what you're looking to do, like this is a nice thick piece of aluminum. Even some of these, they're a little bit thinner, but they got like the reinforcements running all the way down. If you were to compare that to something like this, which is one of these actual $100 Amazon stands, you could see it's not as strong and it's all just kind of galvanized stuff. You can grab the Amazon stuff and just kind of give it one of these and it does the warp, which is insane. With the EG4 stuff, it doesn't matter what you grab, like you're not gonna bend this, dude. This is good aluminum. This is nice. The one thing that it didn't come with though is instructions. It came with a checklist of everything in the box. No instruction manual. You can get it on your phone, which is nice. It'd be kind of cool to have a paper copy.
Once you get one of each size of these little U-brackets mounted up on the arms, the legs are actually kind of cool. So you basically just bolt the shorter little leg piece into the footing. And then you actually have this fully adjustable slider to help you choose the angle of your panel stand. There's two little set screws that you can loosen. This slides in and out, and then you basically just fire a bolt through the position that you want to lock it in at. It even has the degrees markings on the back, so you can make sure that this is at the proper angle and you're not just eyeballing it. And then basically you bolt that into the foot, you go ahead and grab one of the arms that we just built, and it kind of just completes this triangle, which is pretty much the entire stand.
So this part's actually pretty cool. The two empty holes that we left on this arm, leg, we basically bolt this bracket in, and it has a little slider on the back. Because right now the instructions are actually telling you to go ahead and like secure this to the ground, wherever it is, wherever you want it. And you don't have to worry about it being super exact, because you can, once we bolt this on here, it's gonna allow you to slide the cross rails. So if it's not all perfectly spaced, it still works. That's pretty cool.
And as usual, we don't have somewhere that we want to permanently mount this, so we're gonna go ahead and build a quick little base. I picked up a 12-foot 4x4, which is actually a foot narrower than the overall dimensions recommend you install this thing at, but like I just said with the little sliders, it doesn't really matter. And then I basically just put 3 feet across the bottom of this, and I offset them a couple inches towards the front just to help with the fact that most of the weight of this thing is in the front. I traced out the holes onto the top 4x4. That way, whenever I put my screws in to hold the foot, they didn't get in the way of any of the lag bolts I was about to install. And yes, when you see this thing rocking around on the garage floor, that is actually the poor quality of our garage floor, not a warped piece of wood. So I went ahead and screwed these feet on, and then I went ahead and fired some lag bolts into the 4x4s, and then I just measured the gap in between these 2 feet, and we're almost done already. This thing is looking super cool, and just a reminder to everybody, things are not always as perfect as they look on the internet. I may have broken a drill bit inside of here, and my lag bolt went in sideways, but hey, it still works. Once those are all tightened up, we went ahead and threw this thing in the backyard. We did go ahead and try to test fit four of these Sirius panels. Unfortunately, it just wasn't gonna fly. So we went for six 200 watt grape solar panels instead. Still a great panel. The total array size will just be a little bit smaller. And the only problem that I really ran into with this is that EG4 actually only includes six middle mount brackets. So I actually had to go into the toolbox and steal some middle mount brackets from a different panel stand that we weren't using at the moment to actually go ahead and secure all six panels to this stand. But otherwise, the rest was a breeze.
All right, check this thing out. This actually looks really, really good. It said you should be able to build it in about half an hour. I would say if you've built them before, you could probably build it in half an hour. It took me about an hour, not including like the base or whatever. If you were to actually install this, it would take you a lot more than 30 minutes. But to answer the original question of if you should buy something like this, is it worth the hype? What is the deal with it? I'm gonna start by telling you the things that I don't like about the EG4 Bright Mount. First up, the instructions are not beginner friendly. I understood them just fine, but they tell you to install the M8x70 bolt and the bolts aren't labeled or anything. So you don't know, like if you don't know, you don't know. There's like three or four different length bolts that you gotta put in the correct spots, and not a big deal. But if you're very, very brand new, take your time and read the instructions. They're not perfectly clear. The second thing I don't like is the sliders that I was all fired up about. They're insanely frustrating. They actually need to be thicker to go inside of the rails, like the cross rails. They were continuously popping out and just causing me a headache. The slightest movement would just pop the rail right off. And when you're tightening it, you have to like line it up perfectly. It's really weird. They're really finicky. You would think it would be a bigger slider that wouldn't just come out of a hole on the rail. And the last thing that I don't like about this is it should have come with more mid clamps. It's a giant rack. It came with six mid clamps. So that's basically, you get four panels on this thing with the mid clamps it came with. You would think, considering you could fit six 200 watt panels on here, it would come with some more mid mounts. I would have been frustrated if I didn't already have more mid mounts to use. When it comes to things I like about this though, it's properly grounded and I really, really like that. Underneath each panel where the mount is that screws it to the sliders, there's actually like a little washer with a bunch of teeth on it so that when you tighten it down, it bites into the panel and it bites into the actual bright mount. And then on the end, there's a ground wire with a little screw thing, clamp thing that we installed. And you ground that to the earth and it is a properly grounded system. Not all panel stands come with that. And so it's really cool that this is properly grounded and it came with the right stuff to get it done. Being someone that lives more in the north, I really like the easy adjustability and the fact that it says like the degrees. You go under there, undo four bolts, tilt it down for the winter, tighten it back up in the spring, come tilt it back up, change your angles, you're good to go. It's actually pretty easy to do. There's lots of legs. Another gripe I had with the Amazon one was it sags in the middle. This one has four legs, can support tons of weight, snow load, all that kind of stuff. You can already see it's like perfectly straight across the top. The Amazon one had a huge bow. And honestly, for the quality of the materials you're getting, I would say it's not super expensive. All of the pieces that bolt together, all the little sliders and brackets and cross pieces and arms have grooves and textures. They grab each other. The same thing that you use for the grounding is actually used on the middle mounts that secure the two slider rails together. So like nothing's going anywhere. Nothing feels cheap. Nothing feels flimsy. So to answer the question, is it worth the hype? I will put it like this. I would recommend to a friend that if they could save the extra bit of money to get something like this over some of the cheaper options. The Amazon ones, get it done. There's no doubt about that. Your panels are outside, they're in the sun, you're making power. If that's all you need, go for it. Like, I feel confident in this. This winter, I'm going to have a problem with the Amazon panel stand, I can guarantee it. So that's where I'm at. Let me know what you guys think. Let me know if you have one, your experience. Leave some comments down below. Help some other people out who may be in the market shopping around. That is all we got for you guys. I'll catch you in the next one. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.